Okay, students, so in today's lesson, we are going to discuss about the official letters. Now, when we actually talk about the modern world, you know, basically these days, people prefer to send short, relevant messages by telephone, fax machine, teleprinter, email, or WhatsApp. They have little time or, you know, even inclination to write long letters. Email has kept the art of writing alive, no doubt is the true fact. And official letters too are indispensable part of our life whenever we talk about official letters. In fact, letter writing has its own utility. We actually cannot do without letters. Somewhere or the other, the need always arises where we find that we feel the need or the necessity of writing letters. So letters, they have their own advantages and they can be used to share the thoughts and feelings. They can be used to convey the messages, which we sometimes hesitate to speak on phone or speak to a person in presence. And we express ourselves through the written words. Letters can also be used to invite or if you want to complain, make a complaint. We write letters to our friends, relatives. We write letters to different officials. We write letters to editors, businessmen for various purposes, right? So if we talk about letters, this we have already read that letters are divided in two parts, that is formal and informal letters. Informal letters include those which we basically write to relatives and friends, right? And the style, the tone of writing is also very informal. But if we talk about writing formal letters, the tone or the style, it also is formal and it is objective. The purpose, it should be clearly stated when you are writing an official or formal letter. So formal letter is written to an official, a businessman, an editor, etc. Right? So when we talk about the formal letters, we write formal letters to make inquiries, complaints, recommendations, when we want certain things to be informed to others, or when you want to make an appeal to someone for some favor, when you want to persuade others to such a certain kind of viewpoint, or when you warn somebody against something undesirable, or when you want to get your problems solved, or you simply just want to express your opinion onto a matter of general concern, then we go for writing the formal letter. And today, the letter that we are going to discuss is the formal letters category. It is the official letters. So official letters are written by an individual or on behalf of an organization. It is addressed to the concerned official of a bank, a gas agency, a telephone department, police department, municipal authority, etc., with a view to seek some information or addressing a problem or seeking relief or just to give some suggestions for the improvement. So in all these cases, we go for writing official letters. Right, students? And in your syllabus, you will be getting two types of official letter. One is the letter of complaint and the other one is letters of inquiry. So official letter, letter of complaint is written to address any type of wrongdoing. When you see that something is not fair, something unjust is being done or happening to someone, certain offense if you want to report about, any grievance you want to report about, resentment arising out of any services, kahin par koi services mein koi flaw hai, unfulfilled hai. If you want to talk about other problems like rash driving, poor treatment of street dogs, you can straight away write to the authority concerned and talk about the problem and ask for the remedial solutions as well. So for that purpose, we write letters of complaint. Letters of inquiry. A letter of inquiry asks someone for specific information. That is when you want to inquire something from someone. Now, here I would like to make this clear about the spelling of enquiry and inquiry. The meaning is same. These are two variants, one which starts with I and the other one that starts with E. Both are same. You can use either word. So, a letter of inquiry asks someone for specific information. It could be written with respect to an item that a person is interested in, a course that a person wants to study, a vacation trip that a person wants to go on, etc. Suppose aapne kahin ghumne jana hai and you plan for the vacation and you want to hire the services of certain travel agency, so you make inquiries from there and there you write a letter for those inquiries. Suppose you want to take admission in certain institute, so there you make an inquiry about all the formalities required, the fee structure, etc. So in those cases, with the letters that we write those under the heading letters of inquiry. Now, talking about the marking scheme, the marking scheme is for 5 marks in your syllabus. 1 mark is for format. So proper layout has to be maintained. And when we write letters, it includes sender's address, date, receiver's address, subject, salutation, complimentary clause, and it is the part of the format. Then is the content, which is 2 marks. Relevant ideas to be presented in a coherent manner. Coherent manner, that means the idea should be properly linked with, the thoughts should be united enough to convey a proper meaning. So appropriate connectors are to be used. Divide the paragraphs into, divide different thoughts into different paragraphs. So when you're talking about problems, write it in a separate. And if you're talking about remedies, write it separately there. So it should be in minimum 3 paragraphs, the introduction, the main body, and the conclusion. Then is the expression, the 2 marks, which is divided there, which includes the grammatical accuracy, spellings, right? So that way the marks are divided, then coherence, relevance of the ideas and style, 1 mark. So this way the 2 marks are bifurcated, grammatical accuracy and spellings, and then coherence, relevance of ideas and style. Word limit for your letter is 120 to 150 words. So do not exceed, don't write elaborated explanation. Don't go for unnecessary explanation of things. Be very precise to the point. One important thing is, no mark is awarded if only the format is given. This thing has to be kept in mind. Sometimes what students do, they don't write the content and they just write the format just to score marks there. But remember this, keep this in mind. If you just simply write the format, marks are not awarded. So no mark is given there. Credit is given to the candidate's originality and creativity in presenting the ideas. So think openly. Come with some practical suggestions and remedies when you are giving there, when you are writing those solutions in your letters. Because the credit is given to those candidates who present their original ideas. Some creativity is found there, the way they express themselves, the problem there in the letters, it is considered. And mixing up of traditional and modern layout is not acceptable. When we talk about the layout, we use the block format in writing letters. What is the block format that I'll explain in the next slide? So those formats are not to be mixed up, traditional and the modern layout. You have to write any one method and it is preferably asked to write in the block format. Is it clear, students? So when we are writing, these are the important parts of our letter. Sender's address, inside or the addressee's address, salutation, subject, or you can go for the salutation after the subject. You can write it before the subject as well, then the body and the subscription, right? So this is the block format. That means your letter starts from the extreme left. You don't have to shift to change the paragraph towards the right side. everything will start from the left margin. So first thing first that you are going to write is sender's address. And again, in block format, we don't put any punctuation mark at the end of each line. We can use commas to divide two distinct things in one line. Like if you are writing house number, street number, colony name, then you can put comma there. But at the end, you will not put any punctuation mark there. Then the date. Now this is the date. These two format, choose any one to write the date. You can either write this way, 7 May 2021 or May 7, 2021. But don't write in a way where you write 7/5/20 or hyphen. Putting hyphen in between, that is not taken into consideration. You'll lose marks there if you go for this kind of paragraph. Then the inside or the addressee's address. Inside or the addressee's address mein kya hota hai? Sabse pehle you have to write the designation of the addressee. That means aap kisko chitthi likh rahe ho, wo likhna bahut zaruri hai. Addressee kaun hai? Director of the company hai, koi municipal corporation ka director hai ya commissioner hai, right? So that way you need to mention the designation there. Ki to whom are you addressing the letter, that is important. Okay, then the official address of that addressee. After that, you write the salutation. And in official letters, we use dear sir or ma'am, or you can simply put sir or ma'am. When you're writing madam, if you're skipping D there, kindly put an apostrophe comma, M-A comma A-M, right? Don't write M-A-M, because when you write M-A-M, it actually becomes M-A-N, man ban jata hai. So, आप मिस्टेक्स कमिट करते हो व्हाइल राइटिंग, यू इग्नोर दीज सिंपल लिटिल थिंग्स व्हाइल राइटिंग लेटर्स, प्लीज डोंट गो फॉर दैट. ईदर राइट डियर सर, डियर मैम, और सर और मैम. देन यू राइट द सब्जेक्ट. नाउ इफ यू रिमेंबर व्हाइल एक्सप्लेनिंग द एडिटोरियल लेटर, आई हैड टोल्ड यू वन थिंग रिगार्डिंग द सब्जेक्ट, दैट नाउ द सब्जेक्ट विल नॉट स्टार्ट विद द वर्ब. सो इफ यू आर राइटिंग complaint, so do write complaint about so and so issue. Don't write complaining about, inquiring about. No, you can simply put a noun, start with noun or referring, making the statement in some other way, but don't write the verb there. Then you start with the content. The content should be in three distinct paragraphs. First should be the introductory para, where you introduce your problem, then main body where you elaborate your problem, and then in the concluding para where you ask for remedial solutions and you also provide suggestion there. And if you miss out this, you lose one mark there, because the content is divided in two parts, one mark for the problem, one mark for the remedy. Then comes the complimentary clause, where you write yours faithfully. You can always write truly or sincerely as well. Then you write, give the signature there, then you write the full name in capital there. Enclosures, if any. Suppose you are attaching anything with your letter, then you can also write in the enclosures by writing number one, number two. Whatever you have attached with the letter, you write in the enclosures. If you are not writing anything, you are not attaching anything, you can avoid the enclosure part here. Right? I hope the format is clear. And see, the left margin has to be maintained. Even if you start a new paragraph, it should start from extreme left. So let's take an example. You are Sanjit of 122 Arjun Nagar, New Delhi. A number of scooters and cars are parked in your locality without an order, causing blockage of the street. Write a letter to the local secretary of the residents association complaining against this problem. So aapke jo local secretary hai resident ka, उसे आपने शिकायत करते हुए चिट्ठी लिखनी है कि कैसे जो स्कूटर्स हैं, कार्स हैं आपकी लोकेलिटी में पार्क कर दी जाती हैं, जो आपकी सड़क को ब्लॉक करती हैं. सो दिस वे 122 अर्जुन नगर न्यू दिल्ली फेब्रुअरी 20 दिस वे. सी नो पंक्चुएशन इज गिवन एट द एंड ऑफ द सेंटेंस. एंड देन किसको चिट्ठी लिखना है? द सेक्रेटरी को. सो ये द एड करना बहुत जरूरी है. अगर आप ये मिस आउट करते हो तो ये आपका रॉन्ग है एड्रेसी का पार्ट. और उसका एड्रेस रेसिडेंस एसोसिएशन न्यू दिल्ली. देन सर, और यू कैन राइट डियर सर. सब्जेक्ट कंप्लेंट्स रिगार्डिंग द इश्यू ऑफ बैड पार्किंग हैबिट्स इन द लोकेलिटी. हमने ये नहीं लिखना कंप्लेनिंग रिगार्डिंग द इश्यू, राइट. आई वुड लाइक टू ड्राइव योर अटेंशन टू द बैड पार्किंग हैबिट्स ऑफ रेसिडेंट्स इन योर लोकेलिटी. नाउ सी, वी हैव यूज्ड द वर्ड योर अटेंशन. Why? Because we are directly talking to the person who is concerned with this department, with this problem. So we are writing to that person and we are addressing him directly that I want to draw your attention to the bad parking habits of the residents in our locality. It is resulting in a lot of chaos and no place for parking for those who come back late. So introduction is done. Next paragraph. See, the next paragraph is starting from extreme left. हमने कोई शिफ्टिंग नहीं की है राइट साइड पे. डिस्पाइट डिफाइनिंग द एरिया असाइंड टू ईच व्हीकल, कार्स आर पार्क्ड अमिडस्ट टू पार्किंग स्पॉट्स. वन व्हीकल ऑक्यूपाइज द स्पेस फॉर टू थ्री व्हीकल्स, लीडिंग टू मिसमैनेजमेंट. नाउ ऑलवेज इन अ पार्किंग एरिया सम मार्क्स आर मेड देयर, मार्किंग्स आर मेड सो दैट यू कैन प्रॉपरली पार्क योर थिंग्स देयर. बट सम पीपल दे डोंट फॉलो दीज रूल्स एंड दे जस्ट पार्क हैफजर्डली देयर एंड इट क्रिएट्स प्रॉब्लम. Two wheelers are placed nowhere near the allotted zone. This creates problem for other people as they have to then spend a lot of time finding parking spots in their localities. It induces frustration and tension for the safety of vehicles. Now see, various notices and warnings have been given to rule violators, but to our dismay, no betterment can be seen. I request you to take strict action as this is leading to fights between the residents, and effective and speedy action is expected considering the depth of situation. Yours sincerely, Sanjay. Now, what is missing in the letter? Can anybody tell me? Unmuting yourself, what is missing in the letter? I have purposefully avoided writing a thing in the letter. What is that?
Solution.
Yes. सोल्यूशन हो सकता है, हम एक आधा सोल्यूशन लिख सकते हैं, है ना. जैसे स्कूटर्स की प्रॉब्लम बताई कि वहां पर स्कूटर्स को पार्क करने के लिए कोई बोर्ड नहीं लगा हुआ है, लोग मिसमैनेजली पार्क कर जाते हैं. तो स्कूटर्स के लिए सम अदर स्पेस कुड बी प्रोवाइडेड, अनदर मार्किंग शुड बी मेड, फाइन शुड बी इम्पोज ऑन दोज हु डोंट पार्क द कार्स प्रॉपरली. सो वन और टू सम इफेक्टिव मेजर्स इज रिक्वायर्ड एंड दिस वे यू राइट योर लेटर. वन और टू इज सफिशियंट इनफ. So, सिर्फ प्रॉब्लम नहीं बताना है, आपने अपनी समस्या बता दी, सामने वाले से आप क्या उम्मीद करते हो वो बता दिया, लेकिन आप भी अपनी तरफ से एक आधा सोल्यूशन बताओ कि भाई ये प्रैक्टिकल सोल्यूशन है, अगर आप इसे अप्लाई करो तो हमारी समस्या आसानी से हल हो जाएगी. और ये बताते हुए आप उनको यस वन मोर थिंग इज मिसिंग. कैन एनीबडी टेल इन ऑफिशियल लेटर्स वन मोर थिंग इज टू बी रिटन, व्हाट इज मिसिंग हियर. You can always thank the person because you are asking certain services from them. So thanking you can be added, right? Thanking you likh bhi sakte ho, nahi bhi likh sakte ho. Lekin if you add, it seems more polite, okay? Chaliye, let's move on to one more example. You are jolly of class 12. You are interested in pursuing a course in visual communication. You have seen an advertisement issued by the National Institute of Communication, Pune. Offering courses in media and communication. Write a letter to the director seeking information about their courses, fee structure, placement opportunities. ठीक है? तो आइए अब इस लेटर को कैसे लिखना है. And this is the letter of inquiry. अभी जो previously किया वो था एक letter of complaint. So here sender's address is given. Then किसको लिख रहे हो? The director. कहाँ के हैं वो? National Institute of Communication, Pune. Subject: Seeking information about the course in visual communication. Right? आप लिख सकते हो. यहाँ पर verb की जरूरत थी, so it has been written there. You can always write avoiding the verb as well. Information about course in visual communication. You can write that way as well. Then sir. This is in response to your advertisement in the daily dated 12th April 2000, जो भी आपका year है mention करो, regarding courses offering by your institute in media and communication. Now here see one important thing which is I have added. When you are writing in reference to an advertisement that you have seen and you are applying thereafter. So you can start this way. This letter is in response to the advertisement that you have published. Kahan par publish kiya tha? Name of the newspaper, The Daily, aur tarikh bhi bataoge. कि मैंने आपका एडवर्टाइजमेंट देखा था इस न्यूज़पेपर में, इस तारीख को छपा था, एंड द एडवर्टाइजमेंट वाज अबाउट द कोर्सेज ऑफर्ड बाय योर इंस्टीट्यूट इन मीडिया एंड कम्युनिकेशन. आई हैव जस्ट अपीयर्ड फॉर माय क्लास 12 एग्जामिनेशन एंड आई एम इंटरेस्टेड इन पर्सुइंग अ कोर्स इन विजुअल कम्युनिकेशन. एज वेरी लिटिल इंफॉर्मेशन इज अवेलेबल अबाउट दिस कोर्स, दैट मीन्स जो एडवर्टाइजमेंट था उसमें ज्यादा जानकारी नहीं मिली, आपको भी ज्यादा जानकारी नहीं है. सो यू आर इंक्वायरिंग नाउ. आई वुड बी एक्सट्रीमली ग्रेटफुल इफ यू कुड सेंड मी डिटेल्ड इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट इट सो एज टू इनेबल मी टू मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट स्टेप एंड ट्राई टू सीक एडमिशन इन योर रेप्यूटेड इंस्टीट्यूशन. नेक्स्ट, प्लीज फॉरवर्ड द फॉलोइंग डिटेल्स एट द अर्लीस्ट एंड वेन एवर यू आर आस्किंग फॉर सर्टन थिंग एंड इफ यू आर आस्किंग फॉर अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स. Always write in this form. Number your queries. ठीक है? एक tabular form में लिख दीजिए और paragraph में मत लिखो. So सबसे पहला procedure for admission क्या formalities है? Duration of the course, eligibility criteria क्या है? Course fee क्या है? Installment कैसे जानी है? Placement opportunities क्या देते हो आप course completion के बाद? And any other relevant information related to the course, and then you will conclude. I'm extremely keen to join the above mentioned course and would be obliged if you mail me a prospectus for the same in the self-addressed stamped envelope enclosed here with, awaiting your early response. Yours sincerely, Jolly. Now see, here is I've added that I have enclosed an envelope with the letter. And I have not added one thing here. What is the thing that is missing here? Tell me quickly. If I have enclosed something, what will be added at the end of the letter?
Enclosure.
Yes, enclosure. So when you are done with the complimentary clause, leave one line and add enclosure and write self-addressed stamped envelope. Now is that clear to you? कि आपको अगर आप enclosure कुछ add करते हो, then at the end you will write the enclosure here. I hope this example is clear to you all. ठीक है? So this is about the official letters, letters of inquiry and letters of complaint. Now some useful lines with which you can always begin your letters, like I wish to bring it to your notice that. I would like to draw the immediate attention of the concerned authority, right? But here, as we are directly writing to the person, you can always add this word, or you can simply write, I would like to draw your immediate attention. May I draw your attention to the matter of utmost concern that deserves immediate redress? With reference to the above mentioned subject, I saw your advertisement in the newspaper, or this letter is in reference to the advertisement published in so and so, dated so and so, and I, after reading your advertisement about so and so, I wish to make certain inquiries. So these are some of the useful lines which we can use to write your letters. Okay, some more useful lines here. I am writing in response. I'm writing to complain about, I read your advertisement for, I would be grateful for information about, this can be written at the end. Could you tell me if I wish to find out more about, I look forward to receiving a reply. So these can be, last four statements can be written in your conclusion of the content. Okay, students? Some tips. Be brief and clear and concise to the point. Remember this thing. Always keep this in mind that when you're writing official letters, the person to whom you are writing is a very busy person. So if your letter is not brief, clear, and concise, then it will be a waste effort, an effort which will go in vain. Aapki chitti koi nahi padhega. So the subject should be very clearly written. The content should be clearly written and concisely written. Be to the point. Don't write unnecessary elaborations. Otherwise, your letter will go unread. Use proper layout. The format for the letter is block format. जिसे मैंने अभी explain किया था. Use of punctuation mark is adopted in the indented form, but it is dispensed in the block format. Indented form कहते हैं जो पुराना तरीका था चिट्ठी लिखने का, लेकिन जो block format है उसमें नहीं होता है. That means at the end of sender's address, receiver's address, the lines where it ends, आपने punctuation नहीं लगानी है, and it is always guided not to mix two formats. Practice the block format, right? Which is in vogue after introduction of computers. Computers के आने के बाद जो block format चला है, because it is used everywhere. Internationally, this format of letter is applicable. So go for learning this block letter format. Convey facts briefly but impressively. Briefly लिखो, but miss out भी नहीं करना है. Indicate the theme in the initial para, then develop your points in the middle paragraph and conclude giving suggestions in the final part of the body of your letter. You should not miss out the suggestions in the final part of the letter. Use simple and direct language. भारी भरकम भाषा मत लिखो. अगर आपको किसी शब्द की यूसेज नहीं पता है, don't go for that. Use simple language. Avoid use of long and high sounding words and ambiguous constructions. Sometimes क्या होता है, आप impressive language use करने के चक्कर में ऐसे sentences लिख देते हो जिनका कोई तुक नहीं बनता. Don't write those words or sentences there. And when you are writing letters of complaint, be very courteous. While even if you're lodging a complaint or criticizing a person, be very polite and charming in your words. Don't use slang in your letter. आपको शब्दों में भी बहुत courteous होना है, polite होना है. बातचीत में तो आप अपने बात के टोन से दिखा देते हो कि आप बहुत पोलाइट हो, लेकिन when you're writing, don't criticize the person. Talk about your problem, complain to that person, but use polite language there. And this is very important part in the letter of complaints. Right, students? So remember the following points. I'm repeating it again. The block format, there is no indentation. That means आप shift नहीं करते हो paragraphs to left and right. Each block begins with margin on the left hand side. Extra space should be left between different sections and paragraph. Paragraph change करते हो तो भी आपने line छोड़नी है. Omit punctuation mark in address, date or salutation. In case you put a comma in the address, use it throughout. Do not mix the two system. Remember to use the block format. जितना नीट प्रेजेंटेशन होगा फ्रॉम द एग्जामिनेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू इट विल हेल्प यू इन स्कोरिंग गुड मार्क्स. आई होप द ऑफिशियल लेटर पार्ट इज क्लियर टू यू. एंड रिगार्डिंग द असाइनमेंट, अ क्वेश्चन विल बी पोस्टेड इन द क्लास ग्रुप एंड यू विल डू दैट क्वेश्चन इन योर नोटबुक्स. आई होप इट इज क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू. थैंक यू.